Hey there, my name's Tim and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use one of these, a GoPro, as a webcam. It's quick to set up, the footage looks amazing, and best of all, it's easy to do.
First of all, click on the GoPro Quick app, which you can download from Apple's App Store or the Google Play Store. Make sure that your GoPro is up to date. If not, download the latest firmware. If you're using a Mac, you'll probably want a USB-C to USB-C cable or a USB-C to USB-C-A cable if you're using a Windows computer. I'm using a Mac, so I'm going to connect the USB-C cable to my laptop and then I'm going to take the door off the GoPro and I'm going to connect the USB-C end to the GoPro. Turn on your GoPro and USB connected will appear on the front screen. If you have the GoPro Hero Media mod, simply connect the USB-C end to the port on the back of the unit. To complete my webcam setup, I'm connecting the GoPro to one of GoPro's awesome accessories, the three-way. Okay, so first of all, let's go to Google and type in how to use a GoPro as a webcam. Now it's going to bring up some options here. Let's scoot down to the one that's on the GoPro.com website. It's going to bring up this page here. And we're going to scroll down to display the current GoPros which can currently use the webcam there, the 9, the 8, the 7. And then just beneath that is a link to this page here, which brings up how to use a GoPro as a webcam. Now there's instructions there for Mac users and also for Windows users as well. So I'm using a Mac, so I'm gonna grab the Mac utility download, click on that, and just wait a couple of minutes for the package to be downloaded at the bottom of the screen there, as you can see. Once that's done, it's gonna open up the install GoPro webcam setup here. So we click the continue button. Okay, so now it's going to install the software. Just got to wait a couple of minutes for the package to be loaded onto your computer. Now the installation is successful. We have to do a full restart of your computer. All right, once your computer restarts again, you'll see the top toolbar there, there's an icon which looks like the GoPro. So we click on that and then we can click on show preview. Just give it a couple of seconds and there you go. Your GoPro is now a webcam.
All right, so we've got everything all set up and we're gonna pretend we're doing like a Zoom meeting right now. So I'm gonna log in using my computer and like launch a Zoom meeting and I'm gonna show you how it looks using the camera on my MacBook Pro and then we're gonna be able to compare it to the camera and the quality from the GoPro. So let's test it out. Okay, so we're going to go into this screen here. We're going to click on launch Zoom and then it's going to bring up this page here. So I'm going to start a meeting here, just a bit of a meeting just to test the capability of what we have. So if I click on start and now it's connecting through Zoom and very careful. We're going to just join with the computer audio this time. Now we're gonna go down the bottom here, we're gonna start the video. And so what you can see right now is me talking using the camera, or talking and being picked up and being recorded using the camera, which is on my MacBook Pro. So the sound is okay, the picture quality, like this room is kind of not too badly lit, the blinds are closed, but you can see it's very, very grainy. Like the footage is very, very grainy. So it doesn't look so super superb. Obviously, if we open the blinds, it'll look so much better. But right now for this test, we're just gonna show you how it looks just using the camera that's built in to the computer. Now I'm gonna jump up here. I'm gonna click on the GoPro icon for our camera. So we can do the treat the GoPro as a webcam. So I'm gonna click on that. Now I'm gonna click on show preview, right? So it's just gonna appear on the screen, partly blocking me. Now on the camera, I can actually see myself on the GoPro camera, and you can already see, although we've got two different cameras, I'll move this one in a second, the difference in the quality, right? Straight away, it's just absolutely massive, the difference that we're talking about here. Okay, so now we're gonna click on the GoPro icon again at the top of the screen, and now we're gonna show you how it looks from some different angles, right? So we're gonna roll down here to where it says digital lens. So we're currently on the linear lens, and linear lens is really cool because if I decide to pick up the tripod like I'm doing now, and I can spin it around, you see how it sorts itself out? And currently the camera is fully upside down, right? Fully upside down. But it's fully upside down, but the camera on this mode here, on this linear mode, means that it's still getting recorded as if it was like straight up the whole time. So now we're gonna show it on a lens which is probably more similar to the one which we're currently using right now on the computer, okay? Which would be the narrow lens. If I pop it on the narrow lens, then it just takes a second for it to pick up and get with the program. There you go. So right now, this is almost the same kind of lens that we're using now. You can see the quality on the one on the left, this one here, yeah, is still pretty grainy, and the one on the right is far superior. So that's a really great option. You can have that one's with the narrow lens. Now there's one more setting that we're going to try right now, and this one is the wide lens. So this one's more like the traditional GoPro fisheye kind of lens. So let's have a look at that one. Scoot up here, click on that one. Digital lens, wide lens, and give it a second for it to kick on in. Oops, going to paused mode. Ah, there we go. So what normally happens is it actually, the GoPro will sort of pause for a second while it resets and goes to that different lens. And right now we've got the whole fisheye effect. You can see how the walls in the room are kind of bent, but either way, the quality is still pretty good. So GoPros are super versatile. Of course, you don't normally just use them inside. You sometimes want to use them outside. Well, most of the time you want to use them outside. So we're going to test out this GoPro as a view cam in a different location. Okay, so right now you can see we're in outdoor location. This is in the Barossa Valley, which is just outside of Adelaide. And that's the awesome thing about this webcam is that you can take it to locations as long as you have a laptop and as long as it's not too noisy, and you can just make it so much more interesting and more versatile than what you normally get with the FaceTime that I'm currently using right now on my computer. Now, I've got this attached to a GoPro three-way, and I'm gonna show you something really cool, right? So you can't do this with FaceTime. You can't get the tripod and move it around and try and give people a different idea of what your location is like. We've got a beautiful sunset right now. It's late November here in South Australia, and around the whole world actually. And the light at this time of day is fabulous. Because I'm on this awesome webcam, I can actually show you how beautiful the sunset is that I'm witnessing right behind me. Check that out. Isn't that just golden, hey? That is just fantastic. And as I said, I'm using the GoPro three-way right now, which is a great accessory. And of course, because I'm using the webcam, I can get a fantastic different angle than anything I could get just by using the built-in camera on my computer. So right now, sensational view, well, not of me really, but of the surroundings here at this gorgeous time of day. Hey, so what did you think of that? I hope you got something out of this video and learn how your little action camera is so versatile and can be an awesome webcam too, with so many different options, and it just shows how versatile this little creation is. If you want to learn more about GoPros, make sure you click on my next video over here. It has some other awesome tips and hints that can make you get so much more out of this awesome little contraption. Really hope you got some value out of this video today, and if you did, please hit that like button, and even better, hit that subscribe button too so you can stay tuned with all the awesome content that we put here on this channel, Adventure Tim. As always, thanks for watching. Thanks you for your company as well. And until next time, we will see you later.